successful solo career is no doubt every singer-songwriter's dream, but sometimes it takes a lifetime to achieve. And Rik Emmett finds challenges around every corner, and he is also enjoying some of the hard-earned success. Watch this. The mere mention of the name Rik Emmett suggests a multi-talented singer-songwriter, but mainly you envision a good-looking man with a guitar slung over his shoulder. From the time he was just a young boy, his first love was his guitar, and he began his pursuit of his rock and roll dream. Rik lived through the best of times and the worst of times as he became part of one of the hottest rock bands of the 70s, Triumph. Despite the success of the band, Rik split with Triumph in 88 to venture off into a solo career. He's pushing himself to the max, rocking with a vengeance, but still trying to maintain his basic qualities of honesty, justice, and his basic need to touch the rhythm of another soul. For Rik, there's no turning back. Let's welcome the man with the magic fingers performing a song from his newest album, Ipso Facto, Mr. Rik Emmett with Heaven in Your Heart. Beg your pardon?
They're very kind.
Oh.
They're too kind.
No, you were very good.
It's difficult to come on after people bounced around in those shoes.
It's much welcome, believe me. The name of the album is Ipso Facto, and if my memory, if I'm right, it's a legal term, ipso facto, is it not? It means as it is, as the fact is?
The fact of itself, yeah. It's not really, yeah, I suppose it's a legal term in the sense that it's entered into contract law. It's a Latin phrase, yeah. Ipso facto.
Give me an example of it. I'm not sure I understand. Is it just like...
If you were discussing something and you were saying, flowers are beautiful, ipso facto, that a flower is beautiful just because of what it is. It is what it is.
So when somebody comes over and says, honey, the dinner's great, you go ipso facto. Because the dinner was great.
Yeah.
The fact that it is. I've been telling Rick that we get lots of people on the show, and I always take the CDs and I listen to them. And a lot of singers, and it's not a criticism, but people have a style and they tendency to have a similarity in their songs, and the style is very much the same. And if I'm in a hurry, I'll start going through the songs because the feeling's very much the same. There is such an extraordinary difference in your ability to play. You play blues, you play hard rock and roll, you play electric, you play acoustic, you play ballad. How many different styles of guitar playing are there?
Well, I think as infinite as how many feelings you could have inside your heart, I suppose. You know, I think, for me, the whole question of making records, you can enter into that game that the music business has of well, you know, cookie cutter, 10 songs that are all the same and we'll market
find
that.
Find your slot and get in it.
Yeah, you know. And I think that's fine and it works well for some people. You know, Michael Bolton, for example, has really been able to just nail that.
Right.
But for me, my interests are I sing, I play, I write, and I want to be able to explore all those different facets.
We talked about Triumph, and Triumph was certainly one of the great bands of the 70s. We have a bit of tape that we'll show you in a couple of minutes, but I guess the big question is, people want to know why you left Triumph and why you went on your own. Was it just time for you to do a new thing, or?
Yeah, pretty much. When you're in a band, you're functioning as a member of a team, and
right.
You have a role to play in that thing, and there's an image that a band has.
Just like we talked about, you're doing this slot, you're doing this kind of appearance, so you're doing this role.
Yeah.
Very specific.
And Triumph had a very strong image. It was an arena rock. I mean, you know, show the clips and there's the lights and we had flash pots and laser lights. And you really, I felt like I was just getting lost in that whole thing. And it was time for me to move on and try and do things that were more personal and take more chances. And when you're in a band, you can't really do that. You can't subject the other team members to those kinds of risks.
Right. Hey, I want to play this kind of song today. Nah, we don't do that.
Yeah.
Well, you'll find lots of it on Ipso Facto, his second solo album. We'll be back in a second with Rik Emmett right after this. With Rik Emmett, this is his second solo album. Rick's been in the basement for a while working on his third, and he says that he's worked harder on his new album and pushed himself to the, quote, rock and roll max to get his best work to date, ipso facto. So we're going to take a look at his video out of this one. This is called Out of the Blue, this song.
Can't you hear those steel strings crying on a lonely Austin night? Echoes dancing in the shadows of a roadhouse neon light. And the air becomes electric, that old feeling's coming all over you. Out of the blue, true blue.
complimenting Rick on his complimenting him, telling how much I enjoy his voice and how wonderful I think it is. But what do you think of your own voice when you listen to it?
Well, I think anybody. I mean, when you hear your own voice back, don't you go, ooh,
that's not
what
me.
Is that?
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
It's like,
it sounds like history. Oh, yeah, out of the blue.
Trust me, it ain't. It's a great voice. There's a wonderful thing going on this weekend. In fact, I'm going to take, my son and I are going to show up for this one. My son's one of these budding guitar players, and I think they're going to be a lot, but there is room for 500. The Canadian Musician and Musicians Institute at the Phoenix, this is only in Toronto on Sunday. There's from 10 in the morning, all day session with lots of guitar players, and Rik Emmett's going to be there at 1 o'clock. You're going to play, and then you're going to talk to
all
the kids.
Yeah, question and answer, and just basically give people some insight into the whole process of being a working guitar player.
So what do the kids ask you?
They want to know how much money you make and what kind of car you drive and, you know, the typical stuff.
Like, did you ever meet Madonna?
Yeah, I did. That's right.
Okay.
I've heard that question before.
I know you have four children. Your daughter's 11. The twins are...
This is the hot seat now. They're
Come on, Dad.
3 years in between.
And the little guy's 4 years.
So maybe they're 10 and 7 and 4. That's probably what...
Okay.
That sounds right.
10, 7, and 4.
Yeah.
And your children didn't know for a long time that Dad was a rock and roll star.
Well, they knew, but they didn't care. I mean, do your kids care that you're TV? You know, it's like, they don't, you know, we didn't make a big deal of it, and so they don't. And until my eldest daughter figured she could get some mileage at school, you know, like from her friends. Like,
hey, I can
and
use
I went, hey,
this.
None of that. None of that, you know.
You have 50 guitars?
Something like that, yeah.
And you've been working on them lately downstairs. You're telling me doing a lot of work on your new album.
Yeah, got the basement studio going and trying to do demos and. It's hard to keep the kids out of there and keep their greasy paws off the guitars.
Don't touch Dad.
Yeah.
This is, at the end of this, this is your bio, and it says, I have a deep and abiding spiritual love of music, singing, and playing. I relish the opportunity to entertain. This you wrote this, to make people smile, feel, and think. You truly are an entertainer that really wants to communicate and touch people.
Well, I think we all feel that we're put here for some reason. That's the reason that I have.
That's the reason you were put here, was to get
I think so.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I feel. I don't know.
No, they agree. We agree. I mean, you sure do. The guy whose starting point is honesty and who craves justice, that's me.
Yeah. Well, those refer to lyrics in some of the songs. You see, there's a song, Do Me Good, Do Me Right, Do Me Justice, every day and every night. So it's a double entendre kind of thing.
This is true, okay? I mean this. I have, every once in a while, I get a favorite album from somebody I interview. And I plug it in the car and I listen to it to death. Bare Naked Ladies and I just did 6 months in the car. This is my new one. Bare Naked Ladies and me in the car. Well, anyway, I try not to. People would say there's Dini Petty with those bare naked women again. Now they'll say there's Dini Petty with Rik Emmett in her car for the next 6 months. I think this is an extraordinary piece of music, and I think you're an extraordinary musician.
Thank you very much.
It's been a real pleasure. I look forward to your next album.
Thank you.
Do you have any idea what you're going to call it?
No. No idea.
No, okay.
No idea.
So that's another ipso facto.
Yeah.
I have no idea.
Okay.
But the one that's out is ipso facto. Mary, who are you voting?
Today, we're dating phone home. I happen to be calling June Paul.